A very warm welcome to all the students. This is Dr. Neha Verma, and in this video we are going to discuss another topic of investment analysis and portfolio management. We will be discussing portfolio evaluation, which is a part of unit number 5. Now before starting with the discussion, let's just discuss this topic on the basis of a query. Let's just suppose there is Mr. A, who is a retail investor and he wants to invest in mutual funds. He has learned from the business magazines that HDFC funds are performing well. As on 31st July 2019, HDFC has 38 schemes ranging from equity funds to debt funds. It is also having a scheme on the fund of the funds. Selecting a particular fund is difficult for him. Now he has many questions in his mind. How to evaluate the performance of the funds and how to assess the management efficiency of the funds. In order to answer all these questions, the topic portfolio evaluation can help Mr. A. This topic will be discussing how to measure the return in terms of risk and how to evaluate the performance of funds and portfolios. Now Mr. A can evaluate the performance of the funds using Sharpe and Trainer's indexes. The Jensen's measure will help him to determine the managerial efficiency of the fund. Portfolios are evaluated by portfolio managers who can help identify a portfolio's strength and weaknesses and based on its performance develop a better management strategy. Even though the evaluation of the portfolio's performance is considered the last stage of the investment process, it is actually an ongoing one. Managed portfolios are commonly known as mutual funds. Different kinds of managed portfolios are available in the capital market. The relative merits of the return and the risk criteria of the funds must be evaluated. So in order to elaborate on the discussion that we had already in this lecture, portfolio evaluation is done after the portfolio is constructed by the investors. Now whenever any portfolio is constructed, the most important and crucial step afterwards is to evaluate that how the funds of the portfolios are performing. And this portfolio evaluation is crucial with the sense also to the investor that investors should know that whether the portfolios are generating the same results with which objective it was in the first place constructed by the investors in the market. And if the portfolios are performing well, then in that case the portfolio is said to be efficient in the market. Now managed portfolios, in other words, is also known as mutual fund. So before elaborating on portfolio evaluation measures, let's just discuss what is mutual fund. A mutual fund is an investment that pools funds from investors to invest in stocks, bonds or other securities. An investor can participate in mutual fund by buying the units of the fund. Each unit is backed by a diversified pool of assets in which the fund's money has been invested. A closed-ended fund has a fixed number of units outstanding. It is open for a specific period of investors. The initial offer period is terminated at the end of the predetermined period. Now there are two types of mutual funds. First is closed-ended schemes, which are listed on stock exchanges. The investor can trade the units in the stock markets just like other securities. The price may be either quoted at a premium or at a discount. The other type of scheme is open-ended schemes. Open-end schemes, units are sold and bought continuously. Investors can approach the fund managers directly to buy or sell the units. The price of the unit is based on the net asset value of a particular scheme, which is also known as NAV. NAV of the fund is the value of the underlying securities of the scheme. The gain or loss made by the mutual fund is passed on to the investors after deducting the administrative and investment management fees. The gains are distributed to the unit holder in the form of dividends or reinvested to generate further gains. The mutual fund may be or without a load factor. A commission or charge paid by the investors while purchasing or selling the mutual fund is known as a load factor. Front-end load is charged when units are sold by the funds and back-end load is charged when the units are repurchased by the funds. The front-end load factor reduces the number of units when the investors buys it. The back-end load reduces the investors' proceeds when he sells the units. The load factor ranges between 1 and 6% of the NAV. Sometimes the funds may not charge either of the loads. Now next, let's just discuss net asset value, which is also known as NAV. Net asset value is the value of the fund's assets minus its liabilities. NAV is typically calculated on a per unit basis. The formula for NAV is market value of all securities held by the fund plus cash and equivalent holdings minus fund liabilities whole divided by total fund units outstanding. Now for example, if the mutual fund holds rupees 205 lakh worth of securities and rupees 30 lakh cash and 6 lakh of liabilities and 20 lakh units outstanding at the close of a trading day, then the value is computed as below. NAV is equal to 205 lakhs plus 30 lakh minus 6 lakh whole divided by 20 lakh, which becomes rupees 11.45. So mutual funds calculate the NAV by themselves or through independent entities. The NAV calculation for a Reliance mutual fund or for any other company are done by Deutsche Bank. SEBI has laid down the regulations and guidelines with regard to the valuation of funds investments. The valuations may be subject to audit on an annual basis. The NAV changes in a trading day due to market fluctuations. The NAVs of mutual funds are published in daily newspapers and on the fund's websites. NAVs are important because of the following reasons. Like for example, they help to determine the value of investors' current investment in the mutual fund. NAV is the price at which new units of the schemes are bought and sold. Also, they provide a base for comparing the performance of various other schemes in the market. Now, performance indexes. When we talk about performance indexes, there have been three indexes which are available with the investors for the evaluation of portfolio, which is Sharpe, Trainer and Jensen's portfolio performance measures. Now, we will discuss all these performance measures one by one. The first is Sharpe's performance index. Now, it offers a single value to be used for a performance ranking of different funds or portfolios. It is a reward to variability ratio. The Sharpe index measures the risk premium of the portfolio in terms of its total risk. This risk premium is the difference between portfolio's average rate of return and the risk-free rate of return. The standard deviation of the portfolio indicates the risk. The index assigns high values to assets that best support the risk-adjusted average rate of return. So with this discussion, it can be concluded that the formula for Sharpe index is ST is equal to RP minus RF divided by sigma P, which is portfolio average return minus risk-free rate of return divided by standard deviation of the portfolio return. The next is the Trainer's Performance Index. Now the Trainer's Performance Index is basically similar to the Sharpe's Performance Index. An investor should know the concept of characteristic line before using the Trainer's Performance Index. The relationship between a given market return and the fund's return is given by the characteristic line. The fund's performance is measured in relation to the market performance. The ideal fund's return rises at a faster rate than the overall market performance when the market is moving upwards, and its rate of return declines more slowly than the market return is in a decline. The ideal fund may place its money in the treasury bills or the short-term stocks during the decline and make positive returns. Now, when we talk about the Trainer's measures of the performance of the fund with the help of characteristic line, the slope of the line is estimated by RP is equal to alpha beta multiplied by RM plus error term, where RP is portfolio return, RM is market return, EP is error term or the residual, and the alpha and beta are the coefficients to be estimated. The beta coefficient is treated as a systematic risk which cannot be diversified. And in this case, the formula then becomes TN is equal to portfolio average return minus riskless rate of interest divided by beta coefficient on the portfolio. So the formula becomes RP minus RF divided by beta. Trainer's risk premium of the portfolio is the difference between the average return and the risk free rate of return. The risk premium depends upon the systematic risk assumed in the portfolio. Now, the last performance measure is the Jensen's Performance Index. Now, Jensen's Performance Index is based upon an absolute term. The absolute risk adjusted return measure was developed by Michael Jensen and is commonly known as the Jensen's measure. It is mentioned as a measure of absolute performance because the performance is measured against a definite standard. This standard is based on the manager's predictive ability. Successful prediction of a security price enables a manager to earn higher returns than the ordinary investor expects to earn for a given level of risk. The basic Jensen model is as follows. RP is equal to alpha plus beta RA minus RF, where RP is average return of the portfolio. Alpha and beta is alpha is intercept, beta is the measure of systematic risk. RM is the average market return and RF is risk-free rate of interest. The return of the portfolio varies in the same proportion as the difference between the market return and the risk-free rate of return. Beta is assumed to reflect the systematic risk. If a fund's portfolio is comprised of all the market securities, its beta will be equal to 1. It will be greater than 1 if the fund's portfolio consists of the securities that are riskier than a portfolio of all the market securities. So any professional manager would be expected to earn average portfolio return of the equation which was given earlier, RP is equal to RF plus RM minus RF. If his predictive ability is superior, he should earn more than other funds at each level of risk. If the fund manager has consistently performed better than the average RP, there may be some constant factor that may make the actual return higher than the average RP. This constant may be alpha, that represents the forecasting ability of the manager. Then the equation becomes RP minus RF is equal to alpha plus beta RA minus RF, or RP is equal to alpha plus RF plus beta RM minus RF. By estimating this equation using regression techniques, Jensen's claimed alpha, the constant, reflected the professional's management ability to predict the price movements. So, we can say that on an average, a fund's performance is worse than expected without professional management. And if any investor is to purchase such a fund's share, he must be selective in his evaluation of management. Thus, Jensen's evaluation of portfolio performance involves two steps. First, using the equation to calculate the expected return, and second, comparing the actual return with the expected return with the help of beta, RM and RF. If the actual return is greater than the expected return, the portfolio is considered to be performing well. So, if you have to summarize that what we have discussed in this particular lecture regarding portfolio evaluation, we have discussed that portfolio evaluation is carried out to assess the risk and return of different portfolios. Mutual funds is basically the other name which is used for the managed portfolios in the stock market. Then we discussed about the three performance indexes which is used for evaluating the portfolios in the stock exchange, which is Sharpe index, which is a measure of risk premium related to total risk. Then we discussed Trainer index, which is the measure of the fund's performance related to the market performance. And then at last we discussed Jensen's index, which compares the actual or actualized returns of the portfolio with the calculated or predicted return. Better performance of the funds depends upon the predictive ability of the managerial personnel. Thank you.